So I thought I would make a quick video just showing you how to calculate the expected chemical shifts in a benzene ring that we'll be doing for our SEP and SPEC experiment. So if we look at the example given in the lab book, if I can find my mouse. The example that they work through in the pre-lab is this one here. Now, when we look at this, the first thing we probably should do is label the carbons so that we can work with them individually. So that is what this drawing is here, labeling the carbons from A to E. So then what you've got to understand is that each of these carbons start out at a base value, and that base value is 128. And then it's adjusted for where each carbon sits in relationships to substituents on the rings. So we have two substituents. We have the OH here. The OH and the COH. Now, those substituents are going to affect all the carbons on the rings. And the way they're affecting them is in this chart over here on the right side. So if we look up OH, for example, and for OH, what you see is it's right here. Okay. For the ipso position, it has shifted 27 parts per million. So the carbon labeled A here is going to have a shift associated with a positive 27 due to the fact that that carbon has an OH off of it. As we move one away to B, that is no longer the ipso position, that is the ortho position. So looking in the OH line, that one's going to be shifted by a minus 13. And this continues as you go all the way around the ring with the meta and para positions as well. So once you understand this basic, you can start to define the various shifts that we'll see. So if I scroll down here, and sorry, I got to remove the chart, but you've got it in your book. Then for each of these, we can go ahead and assign this. So A is going to be 128 plus 27, and that 27 is the ipso of OH plus 6, which is the para of the CHO. So if you look at the CHO, it's attached right here. And the carbon A is in the para position associated with that. So that's where that contribution comes from. The B and C carbons don't have substituents, so they are not adding to your overall shifts. So adding this up, 128 plus 27 plus 6 is going to give us a total of 161 parts per million. So this is where we would expect to see the carbon in the A position in our NMR. We can do this for all of them. So for B, well, B is going to be 128 again. Now, instead of the OH being on the ipso, the OH is actually on the ortho. So looking at our chart for the ortho, it's going to be a minus 13. And then the CHO over here, ipso, ortho, meta. So that's the meta position. So the contribution associated with the meta position is 1. So adding all of these up, we should see this peak at 116 parts per million. And you're going to go through and you can do this for all of the carbons in the rings, so A, B, C, and D, to find the various values associated with it. E, however, is not in the ring. And since it's not in the ring, we cannot find its position based on these shifts inside your aromatic ring. So in that case, you just simply look in your book for the type of carbon it is and where that peak should occur at. Now, this type of assignment will allow us to decide whether substituents are on the 1-2, 1-3, 1-4 positions in our ring. So even though the molecular weight will be the same, the elemental analysis will be the same number of peaks, quite often, all of these types of things factor in, you will still be able to identify what is in what position because of the assignments you associate with the aromatic peaks themselves.